I've got Photoshop open, and if I go to my library and double-click, I can open this image again. And I'm kind of ready to work, if you will. But let me do this. Let me close it. I'll use the shortcut command on a Mac controlling Windows W. Let me go back into Edit, and I'm going to go down to Color Settings. What I'm going to do is turn on Ask when opening if there is a mismatch, or Ask when opening if it's missing a profile. Click OK. Watch what happens when I try it again. This document doesn't have an embedded RGB profile. So you have a choice. Leave it as it is, so don't color manage it. Or my assigned working profile that I set up in Color Settings, sRGB, go ahead and use that one. Or I'll tell you what, I'm going to give it something completely different. Now, this is going to make a whole lot more sense when we get into the chapters where we talk about working with images and color and print. But I want to give you a little heads up here because you might see this. In most cases, if it's missing the profile, you probably want to give it the profile that you're working with. If it already has a profile, in many cases, you want to leave that alone. Let's say leave as is and click OK. Back to where we were. We're ready to rock and roll on this image. But what if in the middle of working on an image, you decide you need to change the color profile based on what the destination of the image is going to be? So if we go up to the word edit on the pull-down menu, we can go down to assign profile right here. That's going to tell you it could change the colors when you do this. Do you want to continue? Click OK. You basically get the same area. So at this point, we're not color managing the document, but we've decided we either want to change it into something else or we need to change it to our working profile. Click OK. You have now assigned a profile. What does that mean? If an image doesn't have a profile, it's subject to whatever device it goes out on. If it has a profile and everything's been calibrated the way it's supposed to be, then you are managing this. You have a drill instructor that's saying, this is what it's going to look like, and this is the color, and this is what I want to see. That's why color management is important, and that's why Photoshop does so much to give you control over the colors in an image.